There is also an etiquette which Allah's Messenger has showed about the recitation of the holy book of Quran. It's been mentioned by Sayyidina Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhum. Imam al-Dailami has reported this in Al-Firdaus bi Mutahhir al-Kitab. Mutahhir al-Kitab, it has been mentioned. These are the words of this Hadith al-Mubarakah. According to Ibn Abbas, may Allah be blessed, pleased with him and his father, mashallah. Allah's Messenger has said, O Ibn Abbas, these are the words. O Ibn Abbas, when you recite the Quran, this is talking about Sayyidina Ibn Abbas, Abdullah Ibn Abbas. You know who he was? He was the first cousin of beloved Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi. Just like Sayyidina Ali was first cousin of our beloved sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Sayyidina Abdullah Ibn Abbas was a son of Sayyidina Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he was very, very close to Prophet sallallahu ta'ala. He was a child and he was at the khidma of the service of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It's been mentioned by Ummahat al-Mu'mineen, Azwaj al-Mutahharat, the mother of the believers, that Abdullah ibn Abbas would be ready during the salah time, the prayer time of tahajjud, carrying a pot full of water, and he will be, you know, at the service of beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and Prophet will be performing ablution, and he will be pouring in the water, and after that the ablution is finished, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas would take that water which is left out of the ablution of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he would drink that. Once Prophet's witnessed this behavior of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, and he prayed for him and said, oh Allah, gave him the knowledge of Quran. So he was considered and is still considered as Sayyid al-Mufassirin, the master of all the Mufassirin who had done the tafsir of Holy Quran al-Majid. That was Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas. So Prophet is commanding Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas out of love, and he is showing him the etiquette of recitation of the Holy Quran, so that we can also learn from this Hadith al-Mubarakah. These are the words. O Ibn Abbas, when you recite the Quran, recite it with most pleasant pauses. Like, you know, when you have to stop, then stop. When you have to move on, then you move on. So recite it with most pleasant pauses, pronouncing all the letters and words distinctly. Oh, that is really very important for all of us, that when we are pronouncing the words of Quran al-Majeed, then we should be pronouncing all the letters and words distinctly, like as if not we are pronouncing one of the words and then leaving the other words because you're tired or something. No, you shouldn't be doing that. Allah Messenger has said, recite it with most pleasant pauses, pronouncing all the letters and words distinctly, and do not dispose it off like rotten dates, nor read it hurriedly like a poetic composition. Instead, take pauses on its marvels, and by this let your hearts move. Let your hearts move, and none of you should have the intention to somehow reach the last surah to complete the recitation early. Rather, study it contemplatively and ponderingly. Subhanallah, the etiquettes of the recitation of the Quran al-Majeed has been shown and been taught in such a beautiful manner here, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, by our beloved Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, that I would like to, you know, quote it again for your understanding, that what we need to do is, Allah's Messenger has ordered Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, okay, when you're reciting it, recite it with most pleasant pauses. Whenever there are pauses, you should stop, and you should stop beautifully, pronouncing all the letters and words distinctly. The other thing is, you should pronounce it so well that you should pay the haq of every single word that you are reciting, and do not dispose it of like a rotten dates, and you're just reading, and you know the rotten dates, usually the people in Arab throw away the rotten dates, like, you know, they don't care about it. So Allah's Messenger is saying, do not dispose it of like a rotten date, nor read it hurriedly like a poetic composition. Most of the people, like you have seen, they are doing Taraweeh and Taraweeh, and what they do is they recite it hurriedly. They are running. Where are you running? Who are you running from? Are you running from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy? No, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when you're reciting, you should recite it slowly. Like I have seen in India, in the subcontinent also, this won't be found in the Arab countries, but India, there are some huffaz, they will be reciting the Quran and Majid in one night. Allah's Messenger has forbidden them from doing so. Why are you hurrying? You should not hurry. Allah's Messenger has said, do not hurry, nor read it, hurry it like a poetic composition, as if like you are reading a poetry of someone, or Shakespeare, or for that matter, of any of the poets. No, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah's Messenger is commanding you, do not read it hurriedly like a poetic composition. Instead, take pauses on its marvel. When you see the ayah, the verses of mercy, you know, you should pause there. You should concentrate there, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the guidance of the paralyzed, or the rewards of a believer. You should pause. You should concentrate. That is what the marvels of the Quran al-Kareem are all about. And by this, let your hearts move. Allah's Messenger is commanding, let your hearts move. You should feel the qiraat, not just in your mouth alone, not just on your tongue alone, but in your hearts. Allah's Messenger is saying, let your hearts move. And none of you should have the intention to somehow reach the last surah. As we have seen during the month of Ramadan, we all do Qatm al-Quran, because that is the sunnah of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that every Ramadan, the archangel Gabriel, Jibreel alayhi salam, would descend down in the month of Ramadan, and he would be reciting out the entire Quran al-Majid that was revealed until then to our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he would be reciting it back right in front of him. That's called the Qatm al-Quran, and there are great rewards for doing so. I request all the brothers and sisters in Islam to do that at least once in the holy month of Ramadan. That was the ma'mool, that was the sunnah, that was the custom of our beloved Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So most of us, what we do is we just want to read through the last surah, and we are reciting hurriedly. Why are we reciting the Quran al-Majid? To get the reward in dunya wa akhirah, to follow the teachings of it, aren't we? So what is the point in reciting it? I have seen people doing that. Please, brothers and sisters, stop doing that. If you have been doing that is a wrong thing, and Prophet has forbidden you from doing so. And rather, he has said, rather study it contemplatively and ponderingly. Concentrate on all the words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded in the noble Quran, and you should be concentrating on all of them. That is really, really, really very important.